It's official. Perth is Australia's fastest growing major market. CoreLogic data revealed that the Perth Home Value Index lifted 1.6% in January and 3.8% compared to 3 months ago, currently making it the fastest growing major market in the country. So let's get into all the details with this month's market update. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest and welcome to our market update video series where you can stay up to date with the markets that matter and find out what's happening in your local area. So REWA President Damien Collins said REWA.com data supported CoreLogic's findings, with the Perth median house price increasing to $490,000 in January. Mr. Collins said the improvement experienced in the latter half of 2020 has continued into 2021, which is pleasing to see. With the pandemic continuing to impact travel and our local economy bouncing back after a challenging year, more and more West Australians are recognising that now is the time to buy. In January, there were 8,287 properties for sale in Perth on REWA.com. Mr. Collins said this is up 1.2% on December, however, down 33.3% when compared to the same time last year. Now, that indicates we are significantly below levels seen a year ago, and we expect more sellers will see the benefits of listing their properties now rather than later. Now, properties continue to sell at a faster rate than they did last year, with the median days to sell sitting at just 21 days, down from 43 days in January 2020. There is little doubt now that the Perth market has swung into the seller's favour and buyers are needing to act a lot faster to secure a property. House and unit sales were slightly down in January following the unprecedented sales spike recorded in December. Mr. Collins said the spike in sales experienced during December was quite unusual. Typically, we see activity drop off in December and January before lifting again as we get further into the new year. Despite sales activity trending lower in January, numerous suburbs still saw house sales improve, with the top five selling suburbs including Meadow Springs up 75%, Yanjibup up 67%, Mandurah up 67% as well, Alkimos up 64%, and Heathridge up 44%. Now, January marked the fifth consecutive month there were fewer than 3,000 properties listed for rent in Perth. Mr. Collins said, there were just 2,826 properties for rent in January 2021 compared to 5,784 in 2020, which is a drastic reduction in stock, and we currently have a severe rental shortage. While in the short term these conditions will entice investors back to the market, it is imperative that the WA government keep their promise to end the rental moratorium on the 28th of March 2021 to ensure the situation does not worsen. According to CoreLogic's quarterly rental review, December 2020 quarter, Perth was the fastest growing rental market in 2020, which is a trend that is continuing into 2021, with REWA.com data revealing Perth's median house rent increased by $5 to $400 a week in January. Mr. Collins said the suburbs to experience the most notable increases in rent prices were Subiaco, which saw a median rental lift of $20 a week, as well as Thornley, Alkimos, Morley and Halls Head, which all experienced $10 weekly increases in their median rents. With rental stock levels remaining low and expected to do so in the coming months, combined with low interest rates and expected gross yield growth, we will expect investor numbers to increase in the latter end of this year, particularly when the moratorium ends in March. Well, guys, that's all from me today. Now, please remember to comment, like, and share this video. And if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, guys. And remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that is action. Thanks a lot. Bye for now.